SQL injections, what are they and how can you exploit them? Coming up right now. Now, before we can dive into a SQL injection, we first need to know what is SQL. Well, SQL or SQL stands for Structured Query Language, and it's a standard language used for accessing and manipulating databases. Now, what exactly can SQL do? Well, it can do a lot of things. It can execute queries, it can insert, delete, or update records. You can create new databases, tables, views, stored procedures, and it can also change the permissions for these tables, views, and stored procedures. So let's look at a basic example of a SQL query, and we'll use the example of a typical login form at a website. You'll enter in your username and password, and then you click the submit button. Now, once you do that, it's going to hit some code behind that form that looks something like this. And what it does is it's first going to grab the username from the username box and store that, and then it's going to store the password into the password variable. And then finally, we're going to build a SQL query using the username the user typed in. Now, this is bad because there's no sanitization on the user inputted data. And what that means is a user can directly inject SQL queries, or rather SQL code, to modify the SQL query. Now, once this code is complete, our SQL query would look something like this. It says, select everything from the users table where the username equals admin. Now, if we were to execute this query against our SQL server, we would get a result as such. We get one row returned with the user ID, username, and password field of the user admin. And as you can see, the user ID of one, username admin, and password secret. And that's basically how a SQL query functions. So let's go back to our web form now. Now let's insert a SQL injection. So inside the username field, go ahead and enter in a single quote or one equal single quote one, and then go ahead and click submit. Now through the rest of this video, just for your benefit, I'm going to show you at the bottom of the screen how the SQL server will interpret the query from the input. Let me say that again. At the bottom of the screen, what I'm going to do is show you the SQL query that the SQL server is actually going to execute. So here you can see how we cleverly injected some SQL code. Now, once we run this query and hit submit, the application returns back an error message. It says fail to log in as admin, then it says it again for moderator, and then guest and ghost. That's pretty odd because we did not type in any of these usernames. And furthermore, why did it spit out four different error messages? So let's take a closer look at this query. So if we were to execute this on our SQL server, the query would look like the following. Select everything from users where username equals nothing or one equals one. So as we can see, there are no usernames with a blank username. So that part is false and it's not going to find anything. The second part says or one equals one. Well, one equals one returns to true. So if that were to be executed, the SQL server is basically going to see that query like the following. Select everything from users where true. And basically, there's no where clause. It's not searching for anything. So the query is basically just saying select everything from users and the SQL server does exactly as you ask, and it returns all the users and passwords from that table. Now, our error, as we can see, is dumping all the usernames in the table. Now that's great. However, it would be very useful if we could get the password for these accounts. Now, how exactly are we going to do that? We don't have passwords and we want passwords. So what we can do, since we're able to inject SQL code, we're going to first try to find the database name that this application is using. So what we need to do is modify our SQL injection. And this is our new SQL injection. And basically we're going to use the union select statement to add additional information into the select statement by the application. And what we're going to do is we're going to select the database names from the MySQL information schema.tables table. Now, one thing I want to point out is this value right here, table schema. While it says table schema, it might lead you to believe that this is information on tables, but this is actually the database names inside the SQL server. So just note that table schema basically means database name. Now, once I executed this SQL injection, the application then spit out the following message, and it says the use select statements have a different number of columns. Well, when I go back to the SQL query on the server, I can see that the table has three fields: user ID, username, and password. However, our query was only selecting one field, and that was the database name or the table schema field. So what we're going to do is let's modify our query. So let's modify the injection query to always return three values. So all I had to do was just add 1, 1, table schema to our query, which gives us the following, and then execute it on the application. However, once again, I got the same error message, no dice. Okay, let's modify our query one more time. Now, if you looked at the query, you would have seen that we have two union statements. The first union statement is trying to select the database names from the MySQL server. And then the second union statement is purely here to provide an end, a proper end to our SQL query. If we did not include this union select 1, 1, (1), then the query would break. So that is required. Now, to ensure that this query always returns three values, we need to make sure that all of our union statements return three fields, 1, 2, 3, and our second union select returns 1, 2, 3 fields. Perfect. Now, when I ran this injection against the application, I received the following results. Our injection worked. However, the only thing it returned was the value 1, which that's not very useful for us. So let's go ahead and try something else. This time, let's change the values that we're setting inside of our injection query. So what I did is I changed 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7. So let's go ahead and run this query. And this So we're going to modify our query. We just moved table schema and the value 4. We just switched them back and forth, executed our query, and bingo. We were able to enumerate all the databases on the SQL server. And the database that we're interested in is the SQLi database. So now that we know what database we're after, let's start to enumerate it to figure out what tables and what columns are inside those tables so we can access the information we want, specifically the username and password. So to enumerate the SQLi database, we're going to inject the following SQL injection. Now, take note that we modified the value here to be table name, which is what it says it is. It's the name of the table. And then we also included a where clause, so we're only searching from the SQLi database. That way we don't see all the tables from all the databases. Now, once I executed that, I then received the following output and was able to find the tables profile, settings, and users. Now, this last output where it says 6 can be ignored and is actually just coming from our union select right here. So awesome. Now we know that there are 3 tables in there and one of them is named users. Well, I want the username and password, so I'm going to speculate that they're inside the users table. So now let's figure out what fields or columns are inside the users table. So we're going to need to modify our query again. So this time we're going to change the value to column name and change our where clause to a table name, to where we're only searching for the table users. Once executed, I received the following results with column user ID, username, and password. And as we know from previously, those are in fact the column names for the users table. So awesome. Now we have all the information we need in order to dump out the usernames and passwords, but we have one problem. So the problem is we're only able to return one value inside this union select query. But see, we need to pull the username and the password and stick them both inside this one field. We couldn't just put username here and then password, because then only username would show, and vice versa. So this is what we're going to do in order to dump the usernames and passwords in one go. What we want to do is combine the username separated with a delimiter, in this case it's a colon, with a password. So to accomplish this, we're going to use the following injection for the username. And how we accomplish this is using the MySQL function called concat. And all it does is concatenate strings together. And that's perfect, because what we're going to do is we're going to use that to concatenate the username with a semicolon and a password. And it's going to take all of that and spit it out as one field. And that is exactly what we're looking for. So perfect. And our query will look like the following. And once I executed it, bingo. I was able to dump all the usernames and passwords from this table via a SQL injection. And as you can see, the admin password is secret, moderator password 123, guest is password, and ghost's password is secret. Awesome. So that's it, guys. That is the basics of carrying out a SQL injection attacks. Now there's actually many different types of SQL injections, and this is just one type. In future videos, I'll go into the various types of SQL injections and give you some examples of how to exploit that. Before you go, do you want to download a SQL injection lab so you can try out the skills that you learned in this video today? Well, check it out. If I get 100 people to comment on this video, then I'll create a SQL injection capture the flag lab and upload it to this video for everybody to enjoy. So go ahead and comment now. But that's going to do it for today, guys. But if you enjoyed this video, please click that subscribe button. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to click the bell to get notifications of my new videos. And as always, I will see you on the other side.